In today's video in astrology, the Libra Scorpio cusps now. Hey everyone, welcome to Astro Scoop. This is Jeff, the astrology coaching channel that does a deep dive into the planets and signs of the zodiac. And in today's video, we're going to talk about the Libra Scorpio cusp, which runs from October 19th to right around October 25th. This is the first of my cusp videos, and any of you that are born on a cusp will probably know that you are an interesting mix of two signs. So for the Libra Scorpio cusp, we're talking about late Libra degrees right up into early Scorpio degrees. So astrologers often differ on this. Some astrologers believe that you can be both signs, so to speak. I don't believe that. I really do believe you have one main sign no matter when your cusp date is. So for example, if you're born on October 24th, you are a very early Scorpio. Even though you're going to have Libra traits, you're Libra Scorpio, I believe you're definitely a Scorpio. So the Libra Scorpio cusp comes at a very interesting time of year where the light and day is close to being more equal. And of course we have Halloween and all that good stuff. But Libra is the sign of partnership, marriage, cooperation. And this sign marries, if you will, and comes into play right up against Scorpio, which is a very intense emotional sign that governs feelings. So combining Libra and Scorpio on the cusp is, there's several modes that this person, if you're born on this cusp, that you may engage in. So one is thought for Libra, sensation, which is also somewhat Libra, and also feeling. So there's thought, sensation, and feeling are all very strong modes. And this produces a very formidable, discerning and sharp intellect and sense of fairness. The symbols for this cusp are twofold. You have the scales for Libra and you have the scorpion or eagle or phoenix for Scorpio. And the scales are very much about balance and fairness. And the scorpion is very much about mastery, control, and power. Personalities born on this cusp are big. Now that doesn't mean that they're loud or necessarily showy or flamboyant, but there's something about their presence combining the Libra and the Scorpio that gives these people a big personality, and there's a certain brand of charisma that these folks have that are very that's very noticeable when you first meet them, even if they're very quiet, introverted, or shy. This cusp shows a strong inclination to being sensuous and anything creative and artistic. And folks on this cusp will often have a natural ability to be both artistic and also very, very penetrating in their intellect in putting things together and putting projects together that are both practical and creative. Hey, it's Jeff from Astro Scoop. Please subscribe, comment, and hit the bell notification. Now back to the video. Combining the two signs on a cusp period, Libra and Scorpio, there's a lot of gifts there, and there's a really, really good sense of fairness, as I mentioned before, generally a good moral compass, and also a lot of recognition and respect for relationships and loyalty. However, some of the misfire or misuse of the energies on this cusp can result in having an overcritical or sometimes rigid attitude and expecting things as close to perfection as possible. Combining a cusp like this that's air and water, air is social and water is feelings. Now, in terms of these folks being introverted or extroverted, a lot of that will have to do with the rest of the chart and their placements of Venus and Pluto. And we can talk about those in another video. But for the most part, these folks, like I said, are big personalities and get their message across and felt even if they're quiet. although many times the combination of Libra deliberation and Scorpio secretiveness can cause them to hold back until the time's right before they divulge any information, and they'll spend a lot of time ruminating and listening to what's going on with their projects and people closest to them. Libra Scorpios are big people, and combining the air and the water makes for a very interesting person that can be both detached and also very heartfelt, often at the same time. And there can be a push-pull mechanism between engaging with their head and engaging with their heart. So this is a very strong lesson for Libra Scorpio people. And again, if you know your chart or you get your chart done, look to your positions of Venus and Pluto and look at the aspects. And there's also other things that can mitigate those tendencies. But for the most part, yes, there's a push-pull with the head and the heart. And Libra Scorpios often have to go through some tough relationships to iron those wrinkles out. I wanted to give some celebrity examples that are born between October 19th and October 25th. Pablo Picasso is another cusp person. In the boxing world, Evander Holyfield, very intense boxer who beat Mike Tyson. A more recent Canadian actor by the name of Ryan Reynolds. He's born on October 23rd, 1976, and he's a Canadian actor who's done TV, Canadian soap operas, and a whole bunch of small roles in movies, and now he's much more of a mainstream star. And Ryan definitely exhibits the Libra Scorpio charisma and likability in almost all his roles. And I feel like when I watch him act, sometimes I see him as a Libra with that smile, and sometimes I see him as a Scorpio, and sometimes I see a little bit of both. And of course, I know his chart too. he has a fairly intense chart. But there's a couple movies in particular that are abnormal for him. One movie is called Buried, and another one is the Amityville Horror remake from several years back. I feel like those are two intense roles that he did that are different than the majority of movies he makes, which are action or comedic. And check those out because I really feel like he displays the Scorpio in his chart very well in those two movies, Buried and Amityville Horror. So Ryan Reynolds is somewhat underrated, and I think he, as he gets into his late 40s and closer to 50, he might get some meatier roles. Being born on a cusp, you combine two often conflicting energies and traits. However, I feel like you're one sign or the other. So thank you so much for hanging out with me today. I really do appreciate it. Please consider subscribing, liking, comment, and sharing. And until the next time, stay safe and be yourself.